Hello everyone, welcome to this lecture on multi-level inverter. This is the first lecture of this multi-level inverter series. In this lecture, we will learn different types of multi-level inverters, and specifically we will focus on only one type. So there are three types of multi-level inverters. First one is diode clamp multi-level inverter. It is also called as DC MLI. Second type of multi-level inverter is flying capacitor multi-level inverter, and third type is cascaded multi-level inverter. In this lecture, our objective would be to understand operation of diode clamp multi-level inverter and along with its features, advantages and disadvantages. So let's get started. In order to get multi-level output of the inverter, it is expected to decide number of levels. So in general, M is used as an indicator of level in the output of an inverter. So if value of M is 5, it will be called as 5 level MLI. If value of M is 7, it will be called as 7 level MLI. Number of levels are concerned, industries are recommending to control THD under some percentage, and for that it is recommended to have 5 level or 7 level MLI. No doubt one can go beyond that level, but as we increase more number of levels in the output, harmonic content definitely gets reduced, but at the same time we get an issues of complexity of the circuit and switching losses along with efficiency. So it will be better to have 5 level, 7 level, at max 9 level multi-level inverters for industrial applications as a minimum criteria. So here you can see that this is one phase and fundamental voltage waveform of 5 level MLI. This is our expected output. So in our inverter, there could be three phases, but we have shown only one phase. So our voltage will be actually VAO minus VOB. So in each positive half, we want output to get synthesized to level V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5. So this is how we can say that we achieve 5 levels in the output. Similar thing will happen in negative half of that output voltage. In order to get such kind of waveform using some circuit topology, we have to go with three topologies which we just mentioned earlier. So let us understand how can we do this. So first of all, in order to generate multi-level outputs or levels in the output, we must divide the input DC voltage of an inverter into number of levels using capacitors. So for this, you can see that this is one phase leg of a general N-level inverter. Here, this pole will be connected to number of level as V1, V2 up to Vn. Now in order to divide this voltage into n number of levels, we need some capacitors. So here one can see that if user is expecting M level inverter, that means M level in the output, he needs M minus 1 capacitor. For 5 level inverter, we will be requiring 5 minus 1, that is 4 capacitors. So 4 capacitors will divide the voltage into 4 different ranges. And voltage which is shared by each capacitor will be given by EM is equals to VDC upon M minus 1. So we will have different 5 levels. First level will be 0. Second level will be VDC by 4. Third level will be VDC by 4 plus VDC by 4. Next level will be VDC by 4 plus VDC by 4 plus VDC by 4. That is 3 VDC by 4. After that, we will get one more level, that is VDC. So we will be having number of levels in the output. So in general, we need M minus 1 capacitors for M level, and voltage across each capacitor will be given by VDC upon M minus 1. Now the idea here is we want any pole. For example, consider you have a three phase inverter. And this inverter has one leg, that is R leg, and this R leg must have, let's say, 5 levels. So each pole of our leg has to be connected to V1, V2, V3, V4 level and V5 level, so that you will get 5 levels in the output like this. So this is simply a realization of simple multi-level inverter using M-1 capacitors. Now let us understand what kind of requirements are there for multi-level inverters with switches. We need a switch of bidirectional power flow capability and bidirectional blocking voltage capability. Second, we want to have less switching devices. This is expected output of multi-level inverter. Second, our switch must be capable of withstanding very high input voltage for high power application. And this multi-level inverter must produce required levels of the output as per the requirement. So once we get all these requirements, it's time to understand different topologies. So now we will focus on first type of multi-level inverter in this lecture, that is diode clamp multi-level inverter. Now you can have 3 level, 4 level, 5 level and so on levels in the output. Here you can see a circuit diagram of 4 level and 5 level multi-level inverter. In first part, for M level inverter, in general we can say that we need M-1 capacitors. So here for 4 level, 3 capacitors are used. We need 2 into M-1 switching devices for each leg and M-1 into M-2 clamping diodes. So here you can see that switching devices are S1, S2, S3, they can be IGBTs, and on lower side we have another switching devices like IGBTs, S1 dash, S2 dash and S3 dash. So these devices are having bidirectional power flow capability and few clamping diodes are connected, D1, D2, D3, D1, D2, D2 dash, D1 dash, and 3 capacitors are connected. For 5 level inverter, we have got 4 switches, that is M-1, and we have got 4 capacitors, that is M-1. Here one leg is shown and that leg has got 4 upper switches, S1, S2, S3, S4, and lower switches S1 dash, S2 dash, S3 dash and S4 dash. Now along with this, there are clamping diodes D1, D2, D3 and on lower side D1 dash, D2 dash and D3 dash. Let us focus on 5 level multi-level inverter. We want to connect point A, that is phase A, to different levels. So that will be possible when you will control the switching of the different devices like S1, S2, S3. So for example, if we turn on all the upper switches S1, S2, S3 and S4, one can see that point A will be connected to the highest upper level. That means that voltage level will be VDC. So here you will get VDC level. Similarly, if you want to have negative output voltage, you need to turn off all the switches, upper switches, and you need to turn on all the lower switches. Now here onward we will focus on 5 level multi-level inverter operation. For 4 level multi-level inverter operation, you can apply same principle. So let us focus on 5 level MLI. So here you can see that there are switches, upper switches named as S1, S2, S3, S4, lower switches S1 dash, S2 dash, S3 dash and S4 dash. Now let us understand the principle of operation. So first thing is to produce staircase output voltage. Let us consider only one leg of the 5 level inverter as shown in this figure. But here we are showing only one leg of that single phase full bridge inverter. Now there are certain steps to synthesize the 5 level voltages. So we want different levels in the output. So all these levels are, let's say first level is V1 is equals to 0. V2 will be VDC by 4, V3 would be VDC by 2, V4 would be 3 VDC by 4, and V5 would be VDC. Now, this A point or A phase has to be connected to all these V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5 level by turning on the proper switch at the proper timing. So we need certain steps so that we will have all these levels in the output. So there are various steps to synthesize the 5 level output voltage. So these steps are summarized as: step 1 is, for an output voltage VAO is equals to VDC, turn on all upper half switches S1 through S4. That means turn on all upper switches. When you turn on all upper switches, the gate signals will be applied to 1, 2, 3 and 4th switch of upper side of the leg. That means gates of S1, S2, S3, S4. And that will produce the output voltage as V5 is equals to VDC. So we will get 5th level, that is VDC. Next, for an output voltage level, VAO is equals to 3 VDC by 4. So to get this next level, turn on the 3 upper switches SA2, S2, S3, S4 and lower switch S1 dash. Next, for an output voltage level, VAO is equals to VDC by 2. You have to turn on S3, S4, S1 dash and S2 dash. Next, for an output voltage level equals to VDC by 4, that is V2, turn on S4, then S1 dash, S2 dash and S3 dash. So that will connect the output voltage to level V2, that is VDC by 4. Now, last point is, in order to get 0th voltage level, you need to turn on all upper switches and turn on all the lower switches S1 dash, S2 dash, S3 dash and S4 dash. After this, you can see the waveform of 5 level inverter that we just saw earlier. So here you can see the output voltage. So here we were talking of this. When we want VAO to be V5 level, we turn on the switches S1, S2, S3, S4. Similarly, to get V4, V3, V2 and V1, we turn on switches with different logic. So these things are actually expected. So using this, we simply understood that we can realize or we can synthesize the output voltage to different 5 levels using M-1 capacitors and to M-2 clamping diodes. Here you can note down one thing, that at any given point of time, upper switches and lower switches are complementary. That means if S1 is on, S1 dash is off. Similarly, if S2 dash is on, S2 is off. Now let us see the sequence. For 5 level inverter output voltage, we turned on S1, S2, S3, S4. Remaining 4 switches were turned off and we got 4th level in the output. For next level, we turned on S2, S3, S4 and S1 dash. That has produces 3 level. Then to get another level, we turned on S3, S4, S1 dash, S2 dash. To get second level, we turned on S4, S1 dash, S2 dash and S3 dash. And to get 0th level or 1st level in the output, we turned off all the upper switches and turned on all the lower switches. So using this logic, one can synthesize this inverter to any level. So I will give you this part as exercise. You can try with 4 level or 3 level MLA at home. So here we are assuming that we have a 3 phase inverter and there are 3 legs, leg 1, leg 2 and leg 3. And in general, for this 3 phase multi-level inverter, if you want M level, so first column is showing number of levels in the output, so that could be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 as per the requirement. So for this level, we need active switches, these are also called as IGBTs or MOSFETs. We need clamping diodes, we need DC capacitors. So for M level inverter, in general, we need 6 into M minus 1 active switches. Clamping diodes required are 3 into M minus 1 into M minus 2. And number of capacitors required are M minus 1. So for 5 level inverter, if we apply this formula, we need 24 switches, that is 24 IGBTs. We need 36 clamping diodes and we need 4 number of capacitors, that is M minus 1. So let us see it whether it is applicable to actual circuit or not. So we will go back to the circuit. So here you can see that 5 level inverter. In first leg, there are 4 upper switches and 4 lower switches. So the total number of switches in each leg are 8. Likewise, for 3 phase multi-level inverter, there will be 3 legs. So total number of switches are 24. Next is number of capacitors required are fixed. Here, for 5 level, we need M minus 1, that is 4. Now let us calculate number of clamping diodes. So here in for each leg we have used 3 upper and 3 lower diodes, so each leg is taking 6 diodes, so 3 legs would take 18 diodes. These are clamping diodes and in parallel with every switch there will be additional diodes, so that comes as 36. So I hope you have understood this. You can try it for other configuration also. Now let us understand different features of multi-level inverter with diode clamp topology. So first point is high voltage rating of blocking diodes are required. Here, if you observe carefully, S1 and S4 are directly clamped to DC link capacitor depending on stray inductance, indicated clamp switches, and they have to block VDC upon M-1 voltage. We need clamping diodes of different reverse blocking ratings. If you observe the circuit, you can see that D1 has to block 3 capacitor voltage, D2 needs to block 2 capacitor voltage and D3 needs to block only 1 capacitor voltage. That means reverse blocking voltage of D1 has to be higher. So when you design this circuit, you need diodes of different ratings. So that care has to be taken. Next, capacitor voltage imbalance. Capacitor terminal voltage levels are different and each capacitor has to block different voltage ratings. Discharging time for each capacitor differs, resulting in unbalanced capacitor voltage between different levels. Because capacitor may charge or discharge as per their manufacturer. So we need capacitors from same distributor. Voltage unbalance can be avoided by controlling constant DC voltage source or batteries. So here for this inverter, it is expected that input voltage must be constant voltage. If it is coming from any rectifier, you need to use closed loop circuitry so that will be maintained constant, or one can have a batteries so that DC voltage will remain constant and that will not affect the number of levels voltage in the output. Unequal switching devices rating. Here you can see that unequal conduction duty requires different current ratings. That means some switches are conducting for continuously and some switches are conducting only for shorting. So we need to decide, due to switching devices may get heated. So one can note down that the device which is conducting continuously may get heated up. So this is the one issue, that unequal switching devices ratings are happening. Now let us come to the advantage. So first point is, when we want very high levels in the output in the inverter, the total harmonic distortion is very low with high levels like 7 level and onward level. So that gives the better performance of any drive which is fed by this inverter or any application. Efficiency is high because all the devices switched at fundamental frequency. The control method is simple. Now let us come to the devices. As we seen earlier, uneven loss distribution in the device. Second is additional clamping diodes, so that makes circuit bulky and complicated as well as costlier. And we need complicated PWM switching pattern. So in this lecture, we have understood what multi-level inverter is. Then we studied diode clamp multi-level inverter for 5-level output. Then we understood the requirement of switches, clamping diodes and capacitors. And at the end, we understood advantages and disadvantages of diode clamp multi-level inverters. Thank you.